Like, if if you add bat and ogre together, they're 6 and 6. 6 yes and 6 denies, that's pretty good. Maybe Mposhka now has overstepped his bounds, though. Vanskor holds the telekinesis until the last second, drags him back, and with that swarm, got a lot of damage with the Firefly over the top. Mposhka should surely fall here. FNG, one more hit. No, not quite enough. The swarm maybe takes a moment, but he finishes it off. And Ghost Stick trapped in between a number of heroes, but he's got FNG in his sights. And even with a stick, it's not enough to save him. Does fall in the end, and I don't know how Mposhka managed to survive that, but they've got a shrine to fall back on.
And I don't really think it's all. You get so tanky with the Treads Dragonlance, you suddenly have like 1200, 1300 HP on your Meepos very early on.
Are you dead to Firefly? Yes, you are, but Icebergs TP'd in to try and stop Ghostick from retreating. The swarm and the final tick from that dragon form will find him in Mposhka. Looks like he might be trapped as well. No mana to TP on him.
And he wants to find himself probably back in that top lane. This top lane's going really well. It was a DK rotation that got the kill on the Batrider, so ultimately a trade that was worthwhile for Empire, given that that's space for the Meepo at mid.
Oh, Ghostick
continues to farm.
Good stampede away. Dryranger turns to fight, but Bat is going in for that little battle in the 1v1. But the two supports appear, and Ghostick will give up his life with the swarm helping out reduce that armor. But I think what we're saying about this ogre is, you know, one of the problems we saw in the draft was, you know, congestion in the jungle.
Goes into the blink deck. Oh no, he had blink. Now he's back with another Dragonlance. So some players go one Dragonlance, some go two, some rush a blink.
Two fights at once. Centaur taken out by the Meepo, helped out with the glimpse, and up a top lane, BZZ's being chased into the trees. Two-pronged attack, both side lanes. You know, we saw them start off very well, but it's rotation from FN, taking tier 1 bottom, sprinting through mid, through dire jungle, all the way to top to help.
Maneuver from him. Iceberg had no idea he was in the trees, and it's a chunk of gold taken away. Top lane, FNG's come in, but I don't think he wants to be up here. There's a sentry and everything. He's dead.
And Iceberg's TP'd in with no mana. He's got two stick charges, though. Savage Roar pushes them back into the fire. Stampede forward though, Deco Phobos, he wants the Batrider with telekinesis, dragging back his Ghostick Bat. It looks like they'll do a lot of damage, but not enough to kill him, and Iceberg's turned on FN, he's low HP, but he's got the damage, the movement speed, the root, the entangle!
So he took like 30-40 seconds off farming to take out down Roach to achieve this, and, well, things gonna start getting worse. He's got like 12 minutes in. What a Meepo performance so far. Top lane, they're looking for another kill. FNG, it looks like, will get the time lapse off and get the kill. So, nice little pickup from him.
That was a really weird engagement as well, because FNG got...
But, ultimately, the Bat doing just fine. Lone Druid and Meepo doing fantastic, and Meepo's ready to find some more kills with this Blink Dagger, although, quite good the initiation he was hoping for in mid.
Stampede and Dragon Form used. No Entangle just yet from the Spirit Bear. They're trying to focus it down. The Dragon Tail. It looks like they'll have enough damage to kill it off, unless they deny. No, they try. The Meepo comes in, the double poof with the ensnare onto Vanskor and BZZ. A Rubik drops and Iceberg's trapped. Nothing left to give, really, without any mana, but the Hoofstorm catches one Meepo only. Static Storm with a glimpse and DK's trapped in. Meepo comes back on through. The TP's not going to save you from this, and BZZ, again, just being run down. There's no way to retreat. He tries the gust, but Meepo's got the movement speed, he's got the slow, and Lone Druid not quite got the damage there, but with a Thunderstrike forward, a triple kill for FN's Lone Druid. And FNG rolls up to the mid lane, wondering where his team has all gone.
Yep. They don't really defend high ground. They don't really farm when put under pressure. They don't split push, that's for sure. Split push is never really an option against the Meepo, unless you're playing like a very elusive, like Storm Spirit-esque hero or like a Ember Spirit or something. But right now, this game just going from bad to worse as Meepo continues to find pickoffs around the map.
Like, you can feasibly think that Team Spirit, when they get BKBs on the Drow and the DK, things get a little bit better for them. But then you're still, you know, staring down the barrel of this Lone Druid. He's got his Maelstrom. He's going to be picking up a Dragonlance now, I believe. But the Stomp comes through. They've caught out one. Ghostick's gone. The Static Storm's good, though. The Stampede won't get Vanskor out of trouble. But King R trying to retreat himself back. The Rubik's still alive. Finally, the Lone Druid's turn to fight. And he's killed off two. BZZ found by the Meepo. Obliterated! Iceberg, I don't think you can do anything here. You've been entangled and found, and I think Team Spirit might be close to the edge here, gods.
Yeah, I think it may be time just to call it. Jump off that cliff, go yep. on to game number two. This Meepo is just falling. Very well-positioned Ogre. Ogre reveals the smoke. You don't want to engage on him. You've got to go on the Meepo. He's just lost his Aegis, but they can't find him.
Maybe they find Mposhka, the ogre, the tanky one, but he's taking a lot of damage, he's sunk it all into him, and now in comes the Static Storm with the Meepo, they've caught them all! Team Spirit! No, no, no! One by one they fall. They did find the ogre in the end, but Iceberg being chased down with BZZ dropping next to him, and the glimpse back will secure this final kill. And like you said, the GG is finally called. Team Spirit tap out 20-7. Chappie's Meepo finishing things off with an ultra kill, and my god, what a game.
Link Dagger, double Dragonlance, Aegis timing, nothing you can do to beat a Meepo at that point.
It really was scary. I've got to give props to that ogre, though. Like you said, going to try that in my pubs next time. Poor man's shield, bloodlust, just go up, help the offlaner, and piss people off to no end. Well, yep, that's game number one. Best of three, of course. We've got some more games coming up for you in a little bit. We'll take a short break and be back with the rest of this series.
Training setup has got Empire off to a good start with some rotations, and they followed the Ursa. So wherever the Ursa goes, that's where the supports are going to go.
And we'll try on them right now. It looks like the setup stuns, and they've got so much damage between them. And BZZ's Ursa, what's he sitting at now? 11 CS and 5 denies. He's currently at level...
Magnus, just to play a greedy game.
Well, speaking of greedy, FNG has left the top lane where he was getting some CS and levels, finds a bounty rune to... maybe tide him over for now, but they're looking towards bottom. The rotation into the Darkseer's lane, not something you see too commonly. Oh, top! BZZ nearly gets caught. King R doesn't have the vision, but he does now! The rocket comes through and they found him. They just need a stun, a rift, and kill that Ursa. Final swipe of Chappie's sword will club him down, and in the meantime, did anything happen bottom lane? Nothing. Things can slip out of control relatively quickly.
Yeah, the Slaughter's, as far as supports go, doing the best in terms of levels until now.
Unless you do
he's
this.
Going down.
Yeah, unless you do this, unless you perpetually find kills, you know, the point I'm making is that sometimes the kills dry up, right? Sometimes the opponents...
Yeah, this is going to be his undoing if he's not careful. Level 4 Disruptor, though.
Oh, nice. I get the Disruption down. Now he's got a chance to Cogs and maybe Hookshot, but the Illusion's in the way. He goes for that Disruptor, and now there's no Glimpse to save him. Vanskull's trapped in a cage of Clockworks, Cogs, and down he goes. The TA wants to fight, but Ursa's being chased down with a Reality Rift forward. Ghostick's still not dropped, but a good crush in from FNG onto 3, and now the RP catches out the Ursa. They're going to take him down with a Phantasm out from Chappie, but no, he's run away, sprinted out. FNG, another big crush, and FN, the Magnus is gone. DK Fomo's back's back, and this is Team Spirit finally looking for a team fight they can win. Take down 5 heroes of Team Empire, and somehow nobody from Spirit dies?
Oh, zoning heroes, you chuck a center on that little top of the ramp and any hero coming in is going to get stomped. Glimpse into a potential stomp.
Well, Disruption to save. Leshrac, I think, is dead to rights here. Yep, it's Disruption into stomp, apparently. That little centaur has dewarded, has set up kills, and now is pushing a tower all on his own. Can even put an iron? Intelligence? I mean, it's not a conventional, like, you know, escape item or a defensive item, but Ghostick. Jumped on by FNG, and Hookshot's back in, actually. Glimpse away, and now they trap the Ursa inside the Cogs with the Slardar. The chase looks like they want to continue this, because they got the kinetic field and 2 hits out from TA. Okay, the Meld Strike clears straight through the clockwork. They push TP's out.
Scouting around, but this is also really good for purging off Empower in these fights. If you can just purge these Empowers off, it just will negate a lot of the damage output of the melee carries.
Yeah, FNG's been going in, and I think that's the last time he'll try and go in like that.
That could lead to some big kills.
Oh, hookshot! Across, Vanskull, glimpses back the clockwork, and Disruptor. Oh, yeah, good bite. Reality Rift in. The TA does nice blink dodge there of the stun, but DK Phobos sprinting away with a surge. BZZ will also get out at 2 supports. We're also seeing cool little things you can do here from Team Spirit with those Helm of the Dominator, Centaurs and Creeps. They just send one with an hookshot off the mark. They just Iron Shell a Centaur, send it in, and they cut waves. They're shoving lanes without committing a hero or, you know, committing multiple heroes to try and do that. But Roshan will be up soon, about a minute and 20. As Chappie, he showed himself, and he's been spotted by a trap, unfortunately for him, into the kinetic field and the crush, and down he goes. The Chaos Knight, that big, big hero for Team Empire taken out. And now another one, maybe 2 hits and gone. King R, just waiting around.
Yeah, he gives him the plus one. I mean, he was trying to be that dutiful support and just sit, try and help out the Chaos Knight, sit behind him, you know, but wasn't able to save him and then gets caught himself. And I mean, we've seen Disruptor pick a lot with Slaughter with the amp damage, but also very good with the TA trap. So they've got 2 really good scouting tools to set up these glimpses and to find kills with. Top lane though, well, FNG, we've seen this one a little bit before. He's going to get punished for some aggression.
Ghostick still going to die.
Got the minus off.
It's on cooldown while he's dead. It's all good. It's all good. FN. I don't know if he looks to skewer this TA back. Okay. He just RPs her and skewers away himself, blinking back into base and regening up at one of these shrines. But again, that's RP on cooldown.
Maybe not, yeah. Should maybe just be a free little flesh kill up here.
Yeah.
Not the end of the world. Again, it's that stage of the game where your opponent's of Aegis, you're just looking to split push, avoid fights. Fleshwreck getting picked off kind of is avoiding fights. It gives your entire team info as to where they are. It allows Magnus
to... I want all of my commands and options to be customizable to my personal preferences. This game's all about me. Oh, dear. Yep. Well, Aegis still on TA. The blink in, the two-man crush. They've got him actually with the side blade. Splash back in. The static source, perfect disruption. We'll catch out this Magnus. We keep him alive for now, but the glimpse back in. The BKB down from FN. It's the hookshot. Don't know where it lands, but it's in the background somewhere with a back wall back again. Empire just being slammed here by Team Spirit. One by one, they're being dropped lower and lower. And deep inside this tier 3 is the TA. The RP back into the tier 4s. The damage coming through. And BZZ's found one. He looks for two, but FNG in the cogs does get taken out. But finally, the CK dies. Team Spirit, they're getting burnt down by Leshrac. The support Leshrac is killing them off. BZZ back through the wall, and Team Spirit retreat, but they've got healed.
We're very low HP.
Oh, that hookshot was sick. Slides in behind BZZ onto the TA, and Miposhka with the Ghost Scepter, the damage output onto Iceberg. The Refraction getting burnt through. He turns to fight King R, but again, he has no Aegis. Hurricane Pike in a second can actually turn to fight and maybe push himself down onto the low ground, which he does. Reality Rift. Chappie goes in. Disrupt is the target of choice, but he is alone. Gets glimpsed back into the danger zone, and this is where Team Spirit will likely take the first tier 3 in lane of Rax for them. Ghost Stick retreating, but one more shot, the urn ticking him down. Oh, not going to be enough with the shrine to help him.
Say he was on very low, close to 10% HP after that initial engagement, but he's just able to constantly have the enrage up, so he's not all too afraid.
Hookshot into skewer. Up. Oh no. No. BZZ jumps in. The BKB's there from FN, but this is disastrous. The Ursa pops the in range, but there's a static storm dropped in the back with a cross from FNG. And they have managed to slow this advance from Team Empire as CK is just respawning. They've killed off the melee racks, and now they just hightail it back to their base. Or maybe not. They've healed up. They've turned to fight. FNG didn't have the crush. Nearly had King R in his sights, but Vanskor will be the sacrifice. Maybe a little bit more here. Iceberg surged up. The Phantasm does nothing.
That's exactly what they will do.
I go up. The glyph is already used as well. Like, that's hardly any commitment out from Spirit, and they've forced the glyph. The FNG Blink Crush won't land. BZZ gets perched up, and the hookshot's there. He enrages and gets force stamped out. DK force back wall. There's the big one, and in they go. There's no second storm. It's dropped now on top of the heads of three. There's no disruption. There's no saving. And Miposhka has to walk into the middle of them. BZZ, the RP. Who does it catch? The disruptor. He's only got the one support, and now comes through FN. He does the right click damage. DK Phobos gets a double kill in the back end, but FNG still sprinting on through. And Iceberg stands his ground on the top of the ramp and throws the Sire Blade into the faces of Empire. With CK the last man standing, you can only imagine these buildings will be dropping soon.
The impure elements distill to their essence.
Buyback out from Leshrac as well. I don't know, Chappie, Miposhka, can you do anything here? I feel like FNG's got your number. He's just going to blink crush you. That's what he's going to do. He's found that CK. Oh, God! What? The TA absolutely shreds him. The CK is gone for 80 seconds. Ghosting hookshots in with a blade mail up. Iceberg pops the refraction, force snap out of the cogs, but turns the fight. He's found the gap. He's found the hole to sit in, and he's killed them all off. Good game is called. And Team Empire tap out of that one. Team Spirit, what a showing with FNG Slardar. An absolute beauty. And I think I might have lost connection to Discord at this point. So, unfortunately, we can't hear the wonderful, wonderful words of gods because I'm not connected anymore. How unfortunate. But we'll be back in a couple of minutes, hopefully with gods returning as we get ourselves into game number 3 coming up soon here. Team Spirit up against Team Empire for the CIS qualifiers for the Kiev Major. I'm Gareth, and gods was just here, but we'll see you in a little bit. For a bit of a kill, FN maybe gets lifted. FNG body blocks, but they still get the lifted Iceberg. Oh god, Fairy Fire's down. FN is two more hits. One more hit is all they need. He's walking up onto high ground. They've got a salve over on Iceberg. He's got the Astral up, but they've killed him off. FNG finds the kill, and now Torrent Miposhka. He will land it this time. But the damage output's not good enough. Miposhka's on the run now, and these two low HP heroes from the Dire team have managed to kill the OD and retreat with their lives intact until King R. Disruption onto Ursa. TP in from Dazzle. Grave is not there. He's got the Shadow Wave instead. The heal comes through, and King R, that DD rune, it doesn't help you when you're being right-clicked down and killed off by FNG and Vanskor. This is a disaster at the mid lane. As Team Spirit clear up. My Spec's on half HP though, FN. He moves forward, aggressively looking for this, because he's got two people behind him. The TP comes in from Dazzle, but finally the Torrent combo. In they go with the Stomp, the Double Edge, and the Disruption will come out from SD. DK Phobos lines up the Fissure, catches onto the OD, but this is not going to be a fight.
That many of your problems with your Empire, you're still losing these lanes quite a bit. FN's still struggling, playing kind of catch-up mode in this mid lane, so... This game's still not going all too well outside of perhaps Chappie's farm and the troll in the safe lane, but... Spirit continuing to find kills. They get another one off of the Metamorphosis, and Ghostick's TP out, barely makes it.
Hey, it does. Looks like it was a Sunder used as well, so I don't know if Empire were playing aggressively into the TP, then he managed to turn it with that, but... Regardless, they find a decent kill. Keep that TP farming away. They're drawing attention away from this this Ursa Warrior, perhaps. Echo Slam and the Fade Bolt. Oh, hello. FNG and DK Phobos just walk up to the troll and say goodnight.
That is... the Astral Torrent combo is not getting kills. The Centaur is the hero that perhaps needs to show up. If not him, it's like the Troll, but Troll's kind of still at that farming stage. Until Troll's got a Helm of the Dominator, I don't think we'll see him get all too involved.
Poor little SD. I mean, Shadow Demon dying isn't the most meaningful Team Empire, who... They're looking for things like Hand of Midas on OD to build himself up into the mid-game teamfight powerhouse that he can be, while Troll Warlord is still actually yet to finish off... Wait, hang on, is he going for help? Okay.
Yeah,
I was really, really worried there. I was like, oh, wait, where's his item? FNG jumped on, Troll, Bash, Stun, X Mark.
Oh, we got the X.
That'll be the one.
That was like the very last millisecond possible he got that off.
The frame perfect X mark.
Yeah. Iceberg's got a Helm of the Dominator. He's going for Roche. May get found out. Yeah, OD's going to check it and instantly Astral's him up.
They've got Stampede if they want to bring more men into this. Iceberg's still in the pit. And Roshan wanders out, and so does Iceberg. Stampede in, Chappie walks forward, but in comes the TB. Metamorphosis is there, the Torrent lands on the two of them. And OD, actually throws the hammer down, but Grave is out from Vanskor. Saves up one, Chappie in a bit of trouble. Echo Slam at the ready, slows him down, stuns him up, and down he goes. Chappie's gone, and this is Empire full retreat now. And opens up Roshan for Ursa Warrior to perhaps go back in once he's regened at this shrine.
But they even used the big ultis. They've used Stampede and they've used the OD Sanities. They haven't got level 6 on the supports. Kunkka level 4 only, so no Ghost Ship. But it seems Spirit want to secure themselves this T1 mid. Very coveted objective here in the early game. And if BZZ can secure that for his team early on, I'll be in a pretty nice position here.
That's a great steal from FNG. Level 2 Torrent. Telekinesis into Torrent is a pretty nifty combo. Empire posturing to defend the Astral one, but there's the Torrent onto two man. The Fissure comes through as well. And oh my goodness, Empire, what have you done? You're going 2v5 into Team Spirit, pushing into tier one, and you have just given away. He is the carry. He is the carry on this team. He has to. Yeah, I mean, slot redundancy is a massive problem for him and will be in the upcoming minutes.
So if OD was doing well, you wouldn't worry too much about your troll not having like a peak farm, but he's not doing well. He gets found again in this mid lane, and that's his third.
But after that, he's still dead, right? There's no four staff or anything. There's nothing to actually get away from being disrupted.
Yeah. They'll do some damage now to the tier 3 tower. It looks like the remaining metamorphosis duration.
What the fuck? He just died to a TB illusion! He disrupted a TB illusion and dies to a TB illusion. King R, three hits and you're gone. The blink goes in. FN maybe has to turn an Astral here, pops the shrine though. Torrent will slow things a little bit. Team Spirit on the advance though, and in comes TB. The Echo Slam from Phobos. OD's gone with no buyback. And Chappie, you're a Troll Warlord. Sure, you've got Battle Trance, okay, but you have no damage. And Iceberg knows this. Runs in with the Whirling Axes out. He does have the mischance applied to him, but now Rubick caught with the Torrent after the Centaur combo. But it's a Grave out onto Rubick that saves him up. And OD is still dead for 30. FNG might just give his life up for this one, but no. Is he okay? He's fine. The Fissure trapped him in. The X mark was there. Drags him back into death. But that is scary stuff. You lose your OD, your SD. Stolen. Iceberg's still there. And Vanskor available with the heal on the Grave. The Weave popped out. And SD will be sacrificed to the gods, it feels like, as long as DK Phobos can catch him, but apparently he can't. X mark from Imposhka holds them out again, and the TP from King R allows him to return to safety, but now FNG is on the case. They see the Kunkka, he'll try and torrent and TP, and actually might succeed. Nah, they've got him. Drag him into the arms of the TB, and eventually, PCZ will find him.
That's a pretty good place to find yourself if you're Team Spirit. You're like, oh,
tier one.
Chased our way to a kill at the top lane. No problem. We'll take two towers here. They've got Metamorphosis. This should just be two towers, unless they defend their side lanes, which it looks Radiant's like DK Phobos showing attack. The push up top. He's hunting no Echo Radiant Slam, but he may not need it.
Fisher. With the Enchant Totem and the Boat combo from FNG! The Rubick Telekinesis with the Steel and FN, not going to bother to Astral or Force Staff, he knew that he was dead. And again,
that's brutal.
He's gone.
That's, yeah, two towers and an OD kill. Well, not to mention the Kunkka kill slightly before that, so yeah, they'll be looking to secure themselves that Roshan.
Ooh, bottom lane.
Slam available, Phobos may have overstepped his boundaries.
Oh, maybe not. FNG's here to save the day. Perhaps he takes out the disruption from the SD, turns around with the troll and got illusions on him. FNG purged up another Fade Bolt, another Urn. Maybe he can kill Chappie before he goes down, but not quite. Chappie survives. The Fissure comes through and DK Phobos will find that kill. A one for one, but always in favor of Team Spirit when they trade a support for the one roll. That's a weird one. Around the Roche pit, DK Phobos was trapped in by his own Fissure, but the Yule Scepter, there's the Blink Stomp, and a good Grave saves him up, and maybe he can turn and fight. He's got no mana, but 10 stick charges available there. No, he's gone. Chappie finds the double. And Empire win a fight around the Roche pit. Unfortunately for them, it's not quite alive.
Oh, that's crashing. They're probably just like, what are we going to do to get ourselves a Roche? I imagine Dazzle may have misclicked the Solar Crest and click the soul ring instead, is my guess there, by
yeah,
the way.
Yeah, that makes
sense. He typed SO and then he like tried to shift Cupid and just click the wrong one. But yeah. Who knows, we'll see, maybe there's a soul ring.
Ghost Stick has found one. The Enrage and Grave onto Iceberg. This might be his death though. He turns to try and fight, but he's gone.
Yeah.
And OD stolen some ints. Okay. And now, Roshan isn't that far away. It's going to be a close one. Iceberg, oh, he's on half HP as well. If they can jump in and catch him, and it looks like they might be able to. The Grave is there onto the Ursa Warrior, but he's on low HP. And the rest of the fight kicks off in the back. They've killed off the SD. TB's in a decent spot, but Chappie, he runs on through. The Reflection is down, and these TB illusions, they're shredding through Empire. FN didn't get much done with his ultimate, apart from killing off Iceberg. And the Boat is coming through, lands onto DK Phobos, but oh no, no! Earthshaker's gone, the Sunder's down, but BZZ's left all alone, high and dry against Chappie and FN. And the damage is too great. They've got him. They've got all four. They've killed them all. Ghost Stick's escaping with a... Nope. No HP. Barely any HP left on him. FNG finds that kill, but it's a five-man wipe. As Empire, like you said, through execution and the superior...
Whatever, but he'll probably just apply one of them and then apply the other to whatever damage is dealt.
They might have caught a couple in their jungle. Team Spirit have walked into a... really dangerous area. DK Phobos is actually X'd up in the back end. FN has astraled another and is looking for a kill onto Iceberg. The heal comes through and Iceberg turns to fight. FN, Aegis and BKB at the ready, and another X mark comes through. The Boat is down and Iceberg trapped next to his shrine and still dies. Another kill, a third one in fact, was what? The Terrorblade? What? How did TB...
I don't know how that happened.
Okay.
I was watching the
OG. Yeah.
Chappie got the kill. I think it was probably a Demonic Purge and then like a Troll Bash.
Yo.
There's a Diffusal too, so they can basically chase him down.
FN's not done. He even pops his BKB for this. He finds the Rubick and yep, one more hit will do it.
He's not happy with FNG this game. Like, FNG has ruined his early game.
Or the game before even.
That's one of those like spite BKB kills where he's just like, I'm using this BKB to kill you because of what you've done to me. So.
16-16.
Tinker does something completely different now. He gets the blinking teleport. Echo,
yeah, the jumpy.
Echo stomp.
The jumpy enchant totem.
See how he does with this. He's going in for a kill top.
Chappie has jumped on, but look at this. Stampede and Boat and kills and death and Team Spirit ripped apart and killed off. The three of them have gone. BZZ TP's the hell away. The initiators get. I guess it's against like Weave as well, right? There's lots of minus armor, but the jump on in. Iceberg is found King R, but he runs away, sprints out of there. The Yule's onto the Rubick, sends him into the air, and Vanskor, is he stuck? Is he trapped? It doesn't care, because DK Phobos, the Grave onto him, jumps himself away, but the slow from the Skadi will make this death inevitable, unless the Is that an Astral from OD? I'm not too sure, but Miposhka and Ghostic have killed a couple in the back end, and that's 3-4 for nil. BZZ last man standing, the buyback from Ursa will come through, but look at this. The TB just gets jumped on by the OD. Butterfly evading a number of hits there from the illusions, and Ghostic in they go. The damage output looks good, and they've killed them off. The buyback from the Ursa not going to mean too much, and that's 5 down for Spirit. Empire with 5 up, and that's game over. 2-1, Empire take it. OD's taken straight after it.
Thanks for watching. If you want more great content, be sure to hit that subscribe button.
Wherever love flows, there is also tragedy. When we're in too deep, and you and I, we got history. Yeah.